Welcome to ONE Championship's Martial Arts Minute. I'm Steve Dawson. It will be an historic night on April the 20th in Manila, capital of the Philippines. ONE Championship's Heroes of Honor is coming your way. The card features matches under the familiar ONE Global rule set, but it will also showcase the debut of the ONE Super Series, a ONE Championship platform that features the world's very best strikers. Also on the card, the return of Chinese Taipei's Jenny Lady Gogo Huang against Team Lakay's Gina Conviction Iniong. After winning the first five matches in her professional career, Huang has come up short in her most recent contests, falling to the atomweight division's top two talents, reigning ONE World Champion Angela Lee and Mei Yamaguchi. The 27-year-old has a true warrior spirit, however, and it's clear she hasn't been deterred by those setbacks. If anything, it's motivated her even more. Huang's most unforgettable triumph was at ONE Age of Domination in December 2016, also in Manila, when she took on Iniong's Team Lakay stablemate April Osenio. Osenio gave her all she could handle in the opening frame as she leaned on her wushu striking to land dozens of thudding strikes to the head and body. Even as Huang completed a slick trip and dragged the battle to the mat, Osenio remained dangerous as she threatened with a guillotine that had Huang in trouble. In the second, Huang found her groove locking up the clinch and completed a beautiful outside trip takedown. Huang eventually found the submission she was looking for, securing a jaw-dropping gogoplata with just over 30 seconds left in the second. She forced the Filipino to tap. The victory earned Huang Submission of the Year, as well as the nickname Lady Gogo. On the 20th of April, she meets Iniong and will look to recreate her success against Osenio in Manila. Another inspiring story of the power of martial arts features Juliana Ramos, a 19-year-old from Miami, Florida. She credits martial arts for her fast recovery after a horrifying car accident. On that day in November 2015, she herniated three vertebrae and fractured other small bones. For months after the accident, she suffered severe anxiety and depression. Ramos had been involved in martial arts since the age of three. By 13, she'd won her first world title at the International Martial Arts Festival in Disney's ESPN Wide World of Sports complex. Juliana has also earned a third-degree black belt in Jun Ri-style taekwondo and is currently going for her first degree. Best known for her high, strong kicks, Juliana has been dubbed Queen of Kicks. And according to her doctors, if it wasn't for her back flexibility and general good shape, she could have lost the ability to walk. She claims that not only did martial arts save her life, but a martial arts mindset saved her soul. It helped her become mentally and physically strong. With martial arts, she believes, people can overcome anything. After 8 months of physical therapy, Juliana trained for 2 months, competed at an international event, getting a first and second place finish. You've been watching the ONE Championship Martial Arts Minute. Come on back tomorrow for more news on all of your favorite ONE Championship athletes.